This video is about Diatone's latest 5-inch freestyle frame, the Roma F5. It's not about one of those many available pre-built kits. I've decided to build one on my own. But let's have a look together what's inside the box. The frame comes with a detailed manual, and although the design is pretty straightforward, it's helpful to pick the right screws while building. Then there's two lipo straps in different lengths, and the carbon parts are nicely heat shrinked. I personally haven't seen it done that way before with FPV parts. Great first impression there. And here's an overview of the rest of the included parts. They come in small plastic bags, partly labeled, and there's really a bunch of accessories with the frame. The front is designed around micro cams and is made of aluminum, and as an Armorton pilot, I really like the look of the front. Some guys prefer two simple standoffs. I for one do love a nice cage design at the front of a quad. The frame features thin but 5mm thick arms. That means less drag, less turbulent air around the arms. Design-wise, they do remind me a bit of the Astro X5 or J5 arms. There's a 3D printed part for the back of the quad included. It's pretty decent quality print and allows you to install a typical Unify SMA mount and a Immortal T crossfire antenna. The bottom is a two-piece reverb-ish looking layout with four sunk nuts, one for each arm. And if you ever need to replace an arm, it's just two screws that you'll have to remove. As you can see, all parts are chamfered. Everything has its little details, like the Roma writing milled in the bottom blade or the Diatone writing in the top blade. A really nice product considering the relatively low price tag. So what's the gear that I've chosen? My gear list for the build consists of a Diatone Mamba F722S stack, a TBS Unify with a Triumph Pro, a Cadex Raytel camera, 2207 1950kV T-motors, R-Line 1300 6S lipos, and the new HQ peanut butter props. Gotta say, they are a very nice match with high KV 6S motors here, and there's a screenshot of the rough tune that I came up with for this build at the very end of the video, so please make sure to stick around if you're interested in that.
A few moments later.
And here it is in all its glory. You might notice that I left out most of the additional parts with my build. That's just my personal preferences. I like to keep my setups as simple as possible. But if you prefer to protect your stuff, there are side pieces and arm guards and everything inside the box. It comes with an injection molded GoPro mount, a very convenient solution, especially when used with a Hero 8 or 9, as both come with those little mounting ears. But guess who managed to break it already? Yep, that's me. But I had to give it a proper test, right? It actually was because I got suddenly attacked by a leaf which covered my lens and, well, forced me to initiate an uncontrolled landing. But that's no biggie, at least for me, because there is a nice 20 degree Hero 8 mount available on Thingiverse, made by Tony, aka FPV Prince. Thank you for sharing the file and make sure to check him out, you'll find the links below. And here's the Roma F5 again, sporting its brand new TPU Hero mount. What a beauty. Alright, as actions do speak louder than words, stay for some Roma flight footage, plus PIDs and raids and everything at the end of the video. Leave a comment below, what do you think about the frame? See you soon, thanks for watching.